Developed by Polyamorous and published by All In Games, Paradise Lost is a narrative-driven first-person adventure about Shimon, a 12-year-old boy searching for a man in a photograph amidst the aftermath of an alternate history World War II, where Nazi Germany built atomic weapons and bombed Europe into an uninhabitable nuclear winter. Paradise Lost is extremely thought-provoking. It effectively uses environmental details to give the world life and presents a form of Nazi Germany and fascism in general I don't think we get in a lot of games. Shimon's search leads him to an abandoned bunker, initially built and colonized by the Nazis to house those they deemed worthy of eventually rising up to defeat their enemies when the surface was safe. While in the bunker, Shimon makes contact with Ava, a girl trapped inside. Shimon's quest becomes that of both finding the man in the picture and rescuing Ava. Paradise Lost's short length of about 4 to 5 hours is both a hindrance and a boon. Within that runtime, Paradise Lost develops some palpable themes, but it also results in a condensed characterization of its two central characters. Shimon and Ava have personality, even charm, and you can tweak Shimon's characterization with dialogue options, but their trust in one another and the relationship they build together reaches an abrupt, rushed resolution. Shimon began his search after his mother died, and during the game, the 5 stages of grief, denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and acceptance appear on screen, announcing new levels. Even with those signifiers, I'm not sure Paradise Lost does a great job crafting a grieving character. Outside a few lines of dialogue, it's not an element that's focused in on, and the world around Shimon seems to take precedence. It certainly doesn't help that, at a few key moments of the story, strange technical problems have been somewhat persistent, and even make the story harder to understand. Issues like inelegant animations or items that don't appear. Paradise Lost's wider mysteries, like who Ava is and what the bunker was, is, and became, are all solved, but solved with an underwhelming level of emotional acknowledgement, most of which is backloaded onto a choose-your-own-ending conclusion. Paradise Lost is a story about destiny, one that's surprisingly spiritual and even a little religious. It's also a story about technology, stating that it is humanity, ultimately, that creates good or evil from tools that are neither. In a vacuum, these concepts are fascinating and provide a great driving force behind Paradise Lost's plot, but after 2 playthroughs, I find myself wrestling with a tough-to-define uncomfortability. The heavy saturation of Nazi iconography and propaganda, especially toward the beginning, is unsettling, leading to one really creepy moment when Shimon approaches an elevator flanked by 2 Nazi flags, and the elevator doors ding open, as if it's a foreboding invite into the steep, horrible descent of radicalization. I don't think this imagery is distasteful or sensational. The ostentatious, gaudy self-aggrandizement of Nazi Germany was a feature, not a bug. About halfway through the story, Shimon learns that the Polish resistance eventually found the bunker, along with its secret technological advancements, and conquered it. Thus, as alluded to earlier, the question becomes, to what end is it ethical or moral to use a specific technology for the perceived benefit of everyone, disregarding any potential misuse, or the fact that its original purpose was a prolonging of hate, destruction, and evil? That is a massive question, and one that Paradise Lost doesn't explore as far as I would have liked. While there is absolutely a place for short games, and short games can absolutely tell meaningful stories, I think Paradise Lost bites off more than it can chew, and its choose-your-own-ending conclusion leaves more questions unanswered than those it began with.